The fundamental idea behind the firm timer design is to provide accurate timing with very low overhead. And what it does is it combines the good points of the one-shot timer and the soft timers. As I mentioned, the one-shot timer, its virtue is the fact that we can have the timer interrupt happen exactly at the time that we want. In other words, we get rid of the timer inaccuracy that we mentioned earlier that plagues normal timer design in general purpose operating systems. The con that we said with the one-shot timer is that there is overhead associated with processing one-shot timer events as well as reprogramming them. So for that reason, what they do in TS Linux with the firm timer design is to have a knob which is called the overshoot knob. And the idea is the one-shot timer expired here. This is the point at which the event happened. But what we're going to do is we're going to have a parameter associated with the one-shot timer called the overshoot parameter. And what that overshoot parameter is allowing you to do is, even though this is the point at which the event happened, the one-shot timer is programmed to go off at this point. So there is a distance between the actual event happening and the point at which the one-shot timer has been programmed to interrupt the CPU. This is the overshoot parameter. You may wonder, what is the advantage of this overshoot parameter? Well, within this overshoot parameter window, there could be a system call, which is a soft interrupt. We mentioned that applications typically make system calls, or there could be an external interrupt. Any of those things can bring you into the kernel, and so you may be already in the kernel at this point during this overshoot window. So what we can do now is we'll dispatch the expired timers at this point of time, and also we will reprogram the one-shot timer that expired for the next time that we need the one-shot timer to interrupt. Normally, this one-shot timer would have gone off here because this is the overshoot window. But even before that, since the system call happened, at this point, we're going to see that, oh, there is this one-shot timer that has already expired. It's going to interrupt me, not in the too distant future. Might as well dispatch that expired timer right now and reprogram that one-shot timer so that it is now ready for the next one-shot timer interrupt. The upshot of doing this, dispatching the expired timer at the point of the system call that is happening within this overshoot window, is that at the point at which this one-shot timer has been programmed to interrupt, that is gone. It will not cause an interrupt because we've reprogrammed this one-shot timer to interrupt at the next one-shot timer expiry event, because whatever action that needed to be taken with respect to this particular one-shot timer expiration has already been taken at this point. And therefore, at this point, we will not get another interrupt. So we have saved on the one-shot timer interrupt that would have happened at this point of time by combining the hard and soft timer in this manner. I mentioned that fielding a one-shot timer interrupt is expensive. We avoided that because fielding that interrupt happened as part of handling the system call. And at this point itself, we've reprogrammed the one-shot timer for the next event as well. So you can see that the firm timer design combines the good points of both the one-shot timer as well as the soft timer. It is giving us the accuracy that we want from the one-shot timer, but at the same time, we are avoiding the overhead associated with one-shot timer by processing that interrupt using this overshoot parameter. Of course, within this overshoot parameter, there is no system call or external interrupt that brings us into the kernel, then we will have this one-shot timer going off at this point. But the hope is that by choosing this knob appropriately between hard and soft timers, we can make sure that we reduce the number of times we get this one-shot timer interrupts actually occurring.